Hello, I am Dr. Arindam Chatterjee, consultant physician, Rampurhat. Our today's discussion will be what high blood pressure is and how to prevent it. Generally, everyone would like to have healthy or normal blood pressure. But what exactly does it mean? Basically, each time when the heart beats, it pumps blood into the blood vessels. This creates pressure against the walls of the blood vessel, and this is called blood pressure. Normally, in healthy person, it rises and falls throughout the day. But when blood pressure remains high for a longer time and left untreated, it can lead to serious health complications. In general, persistent increase in the blood pressure higher than normal is called high blood pressure or hypertension. High blood pressure usually develops over time. It can happen because of unhealthy lifestyle choices. For example, not having enough physical activity, obesity, smoking, high alcohol consumption, and stress. There are some other risk factors that also increases the risk of hypertension, like aging. As people get older, the arteries stiffens up, and that lead to increase in the blood pressure. Family history of high blood pressure. One or more family member of hypertension increases the person's risk of developing the condition. Excess salt intake is also known to raise the blood pressure. Not eating enough foods with potassium can increase the blood pressure and the risk of stroke and chronic kidney disease. Eating processed and fatty food increases the fat throughout the body and it can lead to high blood pressure. On the other hand, lack of physical activity is also linked to obesity and further increase in the blood pressure. Another one is stress. Reacting to stress in an unhealthy way or not managing stress in proper way can lead to high blood pressure. Moving on, hypertension does not have obvious signs and symptoms. This is why it is called silent killer. It puts people at risk of several other diseases like cardiovascular problems, kidney failure, stroke, even eye problem and blindness. Hence, early and accurate diagnosis is very important to manage hypertension. Measuring the blood pressure is the only way to know whether you have high blood pressure or not. And generally, when symptoms do occur, they include morning headache, giddiness, nausea, vomiting, buzzing in ears, and visual changes. So if any person is experiencing some of these symptoms, then one should get their blood pressure checked. Fortunately, high blood pressure can easily be diagnosed, and your blood pressure is one of the easiest and simplest diagnostic tool which can tell one so much about your current and possible future health. It is usually measured with an instrument called sphygmomanometer. A blood pressure is recorded in two numbers, systolic and diastolic. So let's try to understand what do these numbers mean. In healthy or normal blood pressure should be lower than 120 by 80, or it can also read as 120 over 80 millimeter of mercury. Here the upper number indicates the systolic blood pressure, which means pressure in the blood vessels when the heart contracts, whereas the lower number indicates the diastolic blood pressure, means the pressure in the blood vessel when the heart rests in between beats. If blood pressure level is more than 140 by 90, then hypertension develops. If any person have high blood pressure, it increases the risk of cardiovascular disease in many ways. And this risk can be prevented by reducing. If blood pressure level is more than 140 by 90, then hypertension develops. If blood pressure level is more than 140 by 90, then the person have hypertension. If person have BP level higher than this, then he or she is at risk of developing serious cardiovascular diseases. And this risk can be prevented and reduced by taking steps towards healthier lifestyle, like regular exercise, quitting smoking and alcohol, proper diet, stress management, regular monitoring of your blood pressure and regular adherence to the medicine in proper way. If blood pressure level is more than 140 by 90, then the person have hypertension. If person have high BP higher than 140 by 90, then he or she is at risk of developing so many cardiovascular diseases. And this risk can be prevented by taking some healthy lifestyle measures like regular exercise, healthy diet, quit smoking and reducing alcohol intake, regular blood pressure monitoring, stress management and adherence to medicine. If blood pressure is successfully controlled with such lifestyle modification, then it might avoid, delay or reduce the need of medication. So let's take a look about these strategies one by one. First, regular exercise or physical activity. Exercise can be a drug-free approach to lower high blood pressure. Regular physical activity makes one's heart stronger. If one has strong and healthy heart, it can pump more blood with less effort. So, if the heart has to work less, the force on the blood vessels will be less and the blood pressure will reduce. In other case, as we are aware that age and weight gain are two important major risk factors for high blood pressure. So if blood pressure is at desirable level, that is less than 120 by 80, then exercise can help to prevent it from rising as you age. Regular exercise also helps you to maintain healthy weight, which is in my opinion as an important way to control blood pressure. One should aim for at least 30 minutes of aerobic activity most days of the week, at least 5 days in a week. High blood pressure can be reduced by doing regular structured exercise program like brisk walking, jogging, cycling, swimming, etc. Then healthy diet. Diet also plays an important role in controlling blood pressure. A diet with high intake of vegetables, fruits, whole grains is recommended for hypertensive patients. For lowering high blood pressure or preventing hypertension through dietary intervention, one can adopt a dietary pattern such as DASH diet or a Mediterranean diet. Eating less saturated fat or total fat, getting plenty of potassium, limiting the amount of sodium in diet and limiting alcohol consumption. DASH diet, DASH stands for dietary approach to stop hypertension diet. Eating a DASH diet that is rich in whole grains, fruits, vegetables and low fat dairy products and skims of saturated fat and cholesterol can lower one's blood pressure by up to 11 mm of mercury and if the blood pressure is high. Reduce sodium content in diet. Even a small reduction in sodium in diet can improve the heart health and reduce the blood pressure by up to 5 to 6 mm of mercury. If you have high blood pressure, to decrease the sodium in diet, you can consider the certain tips like read food labels. If possible, choose low sodium alternatives of food and beverages that you normally have. Eat fewer processed food. Only a small amount of sodium occurs naturally in foods and most of the sodium is added to food during processing. So, if you can natural products, it automatically reduces the sodium content of your diet. Don't add salt. Just 1 level teaspoon of salt have 2300 milligram of sodium. So avoid adding salt to your diet and you can use spices or herbs to flavor your food. Quit smoking and limit the amount of alcohol you drink. Smoking cessation is very important and to control the blood pressure. Regular blood pressure monitoring is very important. Some of the hypertensive patients check their blood pressure by visiting the doctors. But it is not always possible for the patient to visit the doctors and get their blood pressure checked. So, in my opinion, the self-monitoring of blood pressure is very important in managing hypertension. And nowadays, the automated sphygmomanometer standardized by WHO is readily available in the counter or in the online, and you can measure your blood pressure in a proper way at your home, and it keep a record of this, and it will tell it, it will be so much helpful to know about the current status of hypertension. Stress management. By learning how to relax and manage stress can improve emotional and physical health and lower the high blood pressure. Stress management technique include yoga, meditation, listening to music is very important to reduce the blood pressure and control the high blood pressure. And adherence to medicine. A medicine to lower blood pressure can may be recommended by the doctor if your blood pressure is considerably high, and it is very important to stick to the proper doses of the medicine as your doctor prescribed. At last, I would like to suggest that there is nothing more precious than having a healthy and fit life. Adapting to healthy lifestyle can help us to enjoy long and healthy life. High blood pressure can be prevented as well as controlled in many ways. Keeping blood pressure in the normal range is very important in preventing cardiovascular complications, and it is very much possible to maintain normal blood pressure level with regular preventive care and proper medication. Thank you.